Russian-born cellist Tatjana Vassiljeva has had a sparkling solo cello playing career, but she gave it all up to become principal cello of the Concertgebouworkest, and I'm going to ask her why. Now, you started playing the cello very young, right?
Yes, I'm playing cello since I'm 6 years old. At that age, my mom brought me to a music school in our hometown in Novosibirsk. And my mother dream was that I would become violinist, but at that time it was a bit too late, she was told, because in Novosibirsk, this famous class of Sacher Bron, with young student like Vadim Repin or Maxim Vengerov, they started at age of 4. And at music school they said, yeah, there is a cello, maybe you can try on the cello.
And did you want to play the cello?
Yeah, they asked me, how do you like? And I said, yeah, it looks good, let's try.
And did you always want to play the cello, or were there other instruments that you wanted to play?
My dream was to play harp, because I was watching on our Soviet television a musical program where harp women, 12 girls with beautiful dresses, were sitting and playing this nice instrument. That was my princess dream.
Okay, so you study the cello, of course, and then eventually you start doing competitions. Why did you want to do them?
First, of course, as you are young, competitions are the way, because you don't get any invitation to play a concert. When you win, finally win a competition, and you get opportunity to live your dream playing concerts around the world, then you don't need any competitions.
And what was that point? What competition was it that you said, okay, I've won that one, I don't need to do that anymore?
Yeah, for me it was at the age of 25, Rostropovich competition, which gave me all opportunities I needed.
Did you have to travel far to do these competitions? I mean, were they all in your hometown, or...?
One very, very famous competition, ARD, in Munich. It was 94. Right after Perestroika, quite dangerous. And I remember I was going alone with the cello, 3 days, 2 nights, practicing in a in a train.
3 days, 2 nights on the train.
Yeah. That was fun, interesting. And then I arrived to Munich, and the director of the competition saw me, and she was completely shocked. So they took good care of me, so I finally could rest and do my best. Then after 4 rounds, I was second.
Great.
Yeah, that was good result, but still not first.
And your mother must have been thrilled.
Yeah, my mom asked on the telephone, yeah, why not first? So I had to explain, why not first?
Well, so after winning the Rostropovich competition...
There was nothing to explain.
Right, you win that. You've got an agent, you're traveling the world.
Yeah.
You start what is the most remarkably fantastic solo cello playing career, which brought you in front of many and made many connections around the world with incredible musicians, Rostropovich being one of them, but also composers.
Yeah.
Penderecki and Dutilleux.
Yeah.
Dutilleux and you had a very special connection.
I recorded his piece, Trois, strophes sur le nom de Sacher. And once I got a call from my agent, Tatjana, Maestro Dutilleux would like to get in contact with you, because he listened on the radio and he stopped on the Autobahn just to finish, because he loved so much and he wanted absolutely to know who was playing. Since then, every time when I was playing his piece in France, he sent me flowers.
Wow. What a fantastic story. A very, very sweet man.
Yeah, that was a great man.
So you've traveled all over the world, many, many times.
I have not been to a couple of countries which still have to, but for sure not for playing.
Right. And so, I mean, you are living the dream.
Yeah.
Why then come and join an orchestra?
Yeah, it's not an orchestra.
True.
After 10 years of playing, of touring, time came. Maybe you say midlife crisis.
Yeah, possibly.
And I decided, okay, I lived my dream, what next? I don't want to continue like this until the end of my life, because it's okay, it's nice what I did. I would like to try something else.
And life on the road as a, dare I say it, a woman alone with your cello, that's not always amazingly fun.
No, it's not always fun. That's true. That's quite, it can be a lonely life. It was always nice at the end, but still this unsure, insecure feeling is there.
Well, I'm extremely glad that you had your midlife crisis and joined the orchestra. It's always a pleasure. Thank you so much, Tatjana.
Thank you.